Hi, I'm Chris from Geosoft, and in this video you'll see how to run an inversion with two gradient weighted constraints in Oasis Montage using VOXI. We'll cover how to add or modify data to your model, how to apply a constraint, and run an inversion. This video assumes that we've already set up our inversion and made all the necessary adjustments to the parameters following the steps covered in the previous Setting Up to Run an Inversion video available on the Geosoft website. To use gradient weighting constraints, we'll need to use a gradient reference model. The one we're using here represents a prominent dike hanging below the electromagnetic conductor horizon running north-northwest through the middle of the survey area. As well, we'll use normalized voxel models for the east, west, and north-south gradient weights representing the contacts between the dike and the surrounding formation. Finally, we'll use an upper bound constraint voxel based on a topography grid from the interpreted depth to the top of the conductors. The process of creating these is not covered in this video, as we are just focusing on running an inversion using gradient weighting. Our best practice guide to creating a gradient reference model and weighting constraints on the Geosoft website explains how to create the necessary reference and voxel models for the data used in this video. The best practice guide to creating an upper bound voxel shows how to create the necessary upper bound voxel.
Now we're ready to add more information to our model. We'll add the database containing the residual survey data and define some additional measurements and background removal options. If you remember, this option was also available to you in the prompt that appeared when you created the VOXI session. Right-click the data in the tree viewer and select Add Data. The Add Data wizard is displayed, with the first dialog pertaining to the database information. Point to the database file containing the measurements and 3D locations covering the model area. The X and Y coordinates will be automatically defined. However, you have to supply the elevation channel name, which should be in the same vertical coordinates as the DEM grid. For the DEM we are using, we will select GPS Z final. We recommend decimating the observed data to one sample per cell, since not doing so increases the computation time with no corresponding gain in the resolution of the output model. Once you're done entering the database parameters, click Next. The next dialog in the wizard is displayed. Here we can specify the type of potential field data we are modeling and select the channel that contains the residual magnetic or Bugé gravity data. In our example, magnetic data is used to invert a susceptibility model. When we select susceptibility, the type of data automatically defaults to magnetic. Select the channel that contains the field data. For our model, we will select Mag Final.
By default, the error level is calculated to be the equivalent of 5% of the standard deviation of the data. However, to enable the fitting of the response to the deeper sources more accurately, we are going to use a 20% variability in order to allow for a wider deviation from a tight fit in the upper volume. To do this, we select the Fit Error drop-down list and select Fraction of Standard Deviation and input 0.2, which represents a 20% volume.
For our susceptibility model, you can further specify or modify the IGRF field parameters. If your database contains survey data, the parameters are calculated automatically, as is the case with our example. When you're done, click Next. The last dialog of the wizard is displayed. This dialog enables us to remove the background value from the measurements prior to inversion. The measured data statistics and the best fit linear plane of the observed data are also shown. By default, VOXI will calculate the reasonable starting value and assign it to all voxel model elements. As such, this step is optional. You can, however, modify the background value or the linear trend plane to be removed by selecting the appropriate removal method. The measured data statistics are dynamically updated to reflect the statistics of the observed data after the removal of the suggested linear trend background. The average of the data is around zero, which is where we would expect it to be. Since we removed the background in the data preparation stage and are confident in the method applied, we will refrain from removing it again in VOXI and select No background removal. Click Finish to display the selected sensor data in the 3D viewer. You can toggle the data locations item under data in the tree viewer to highlight the location of the average readings that will be subject to inversion. We also have the option of modifying the data we added in the previous steps prior to running the inversion. Right-click Database or any of the items under it in the tree viewer and select Modify. Since we don't need to add or modify any data here, we can click Cancel.
Now we will apply the upper bound constraint. Expand the constraints item in the tree viewer. We'll select upper bound from the list of constraints and click Modify. The Modify Upper Bound Constraint dialog is displayed. From the constraint type list, select voxel, then browse for the upper bound constraint voxel and click OK. The upper bound constraint voxel is displayed in the VOXI viewer. You may wish to turn off the display of the mesh layer in order to see it more clearly. Upper bound is highlighted under the constraints item in the tree viewer, indicating that this constraint type has been selected. It will remain selected for all processes that you will execute until you reset the constraint type back to none. The gradient reference model is used together with the east-west and north-south gradient weightings. This model has a value of 0.02 SI along the dike and 0.00 SI everywhere else. Now we'll apply the gradient reference model constraint. Under the constraints item in the tree viewer, we'll select gradient reference model and click modify. The modify gradient reference model constraint dialog is displayed. From the constraint type list, select voxel and then browse for the gradient reference model voxel file and click OK. The gradient reference model is loaded. You may wish to turn off the display of the upper bound constraint in order to see it more clearly. Gradient reference model is highlighted under the constraints item in the tree viewer, indicating that this constraint has been selected. The east-west and north-south gradient weightings are used with the gradient reference model to define the confidence level of the susceptibility along the dike. Now we will apply the east-west and north-south gradient weighting constraints. Under the constraints item in the tree viewer, we will select east-west gradient weighting and click modify. The Modify East-West Gradient Weighting Constraint dialog is displayed. From the Constraint Type list, select Voxel, and then browse for the East-West Gradient Weighting Voxel file and click OK. Then select North-South Gradient Weighting under the Constraints item and click Modify. The Modify North-South Gradient Weighting Constraint dialog is displayed. From the Constraint Type list, select Voxel, and then browse for the North-South Gradient Weighting Voxel file and click OK. We can also turn off the displays for any individual constraints to see a particular constraint more clearly. We are now ready to run a constraint inversion.
From the VOXI Viewer menu, click Inversions and select Run Inversion, or click the Run Inversion shortcut from the VOXI shortcut toolbar. The Run Inversion dialog is displayed, prompting you to run the inversion and notifying you of the tokens required for the inversion and your current token balance. Click Yes to proceed with the inversion. If at any point you want to make further edits to your input data prior to the inversion modeling, you can stop the process by clicking the Stop Process icon in the VOXI shortcut toolbar. The inversion will terminate immediately and no tokens will have been used. For our example, we will let the inversion continue. Once you start the inversion item is added to the tree viewer and the progress of the inversion is displayed below the 3D model view. Once the inversion data has been uploaded to the server, you can even close the VOXI viewer. You can return to this session by clicking VOXI Inversion from the Oasis Montage menu and selecting Open VOXI. While the inversion is running, you can expand the inversion items in the tree viewer and explore the current inversion details further. While the inversion is in progress, the only active item is input data. This is a capture of the input information provided for this particular inversion process event. Once this inversion is complete, you have the option of copying the input data for this inversion so that you can run subsequent inversions based on the data and modify the parameters as you see fit. To copy the input data, right-click the database, mesh, or DEM and select Copy to Input. You can also record comments in the VOXI journal where you can highlight differences between your various inversions. You can access the journal by clicking the icon on the VOXI shortcut toolbar.
Now that we can see that the inversion is complete, we can close the process log window below the 3D model. We can add a checkbox in front of the session name to turn the display of the resulting voxel model on and off in the VOXI viewer. We can also clear the checkboxes beside all four specified constraints to make it easier to see the inversion results. The resulting susceptibility voxel is similar to the outcome of the upper bound constrained inversion, except in the vicinity of the dike where it is much more confined to the provided constraints.
Once the inversion is complete, you can explore the items under the particular inversion process event under Inversions in the Tree Viewer. Explore the parameter summary to get a full detailed list of the parameters used for this inversion. See the process log for details of the inversion you just ran. View the predicted response to see the input data alongside the calculated response of the solution voxel model saved at the user-defined sampling rate. You can also view the attributes and color table of the output voxel model, similar to using the Oasis Montage 3D viewer.
The clipping tab enables us to clip the model to show only a specific set of values. We can then also turn on the respective constraints to superimpose them over these results. We've now successfully run a constrained inversion using gradient weighting. This concludes our video on how to run an inversion with gradient weighting. Thank you for watching. More information on using VOXI is available through the resources in the Geosoft website, including a knowledge base for frequently asked questions, additional videos, and how-to guides.